Dear UP community, we have finally reached the end of the year and we can all get the much deserved break and rest we need. This has been a very difficult, uncertain and challenging year when life as we know it has been severely disrupted. However, together we have weathered the storm and come out stronger. I thank you all for your commitment and hard work towards completing the academic program. I know it is not easy working and studying under these extraordinary circumstances. It is through your resilience and tenacity that we have made it. The COVID-19 pandemic has forced us to be critical thinkers and find solutions to the challenges we face. It is a big wake-up call to think and do things differently. And the future is wide open for South Africa and Africa, with our universities playing an essential role in co-creating the continent we want post-COVID-19. The lockdown did not paralyze our minds. Instead, we used the opportunity to begin processes of rethinking, reimagining, and repositioning the University of Pretoria as a university that will sustain and improve high-quality hybrid teaching, transdisciplinary research, and social engagement that is impactful. In this regard, we'll be one of the institutions that are agents and drivers of change to create a new society. We need to use this period to respond with creative and innovative research strategies to address the complex issues that the pandemic has exacerbated. Our students are playing a role by developing and studying mathematical models to determine COVID-19 infection peaks and outbreak trends. We have students creating and manufacturing protective gear and developing and leveraging innovative technology to assist with the tracking, tracing, and treating of infected patients. Our medical students are supporting healthcare workers in the hospitals and taking care of patients. They are also playing a key role in assisting researchers in their search for a vaccine. While we're to socially distance and stay at home most of the year, our students continued their support of the communities we live and work in by successfully restoring an unkept public park in Hatfield, previously owned by the City of Tshwane Metropolitan Municipality. This is yet another project that has brought out their skills out of the classroom and into the community to effect positive change as part of UP's social responsibility efforts. This model gives students the opportunity to use their skills to find solutions for and offer assistance to communities beset with socio-economic challenges. As we close off the year and reflect on milestones in 2020, I'd like us to focus on some of our achievements. We officially opened doors to our Engineering 4.0 Research and Training Hub for smart transport systems and smart cities, including Africa's first independent materials testing facility and national reference lab. We partnered with the South African National Roads Agency and the Council for Scientific and Industrial Research Smart Mobility Cluster. UP was the first university in Africa to host and deliver events on LinkedIn Live. The Lead Up Online Alumni Events is a series of virtual topical debates and masterclasses hosted on UP's LinkedIn page to create a space for dialogue and engagement on various critical issues affecting us all. We hosted the first ever virtual At Choose UP Day. This event was a great success and our video received over 10,000 views. We managed to cement our relationships with many partner organizations by collaborating and partnering with them on several key initiatives that will help to enhance our research efforts as a world-class institution. Our sports stars continue to shine despite the lockdown and the cancellation of major events, including the Olympics. Commonwealth gold medalist Tatiana Schoonmaker clocked her third South African record of the National Short Course Championships in Pietermaritzburg recently, winning the 200-meter breaststroke in 2 minutes 18.2 seconds On top of that, she graduated as well. Another Commonwealth Games champion and the UP alumni Akani Simbine recently completed his European season with a fourth consecutive victory by clocking an excellent time of 9.96 seconds at the Rome Diamond League. Let their passion and commitment inspire us all. I thank you for your patience and commitment as we navigate the new unusual. I look forward to seeing you all in 2021 when we welcome a new cohort of first years and continue to fly the UP flag high. I wish you all a happy and restful holiday. Stay safe.